Yo, what up guys? Welcome to Sneaker Story's first official vlog. I decided this is gonna be the perfect time to do this because I've got this camera right now and it's the first time I'm using it and talking like this, standing with a whole contraption, which is super awkward by the way. But hopefully I get used to it anyway. We are heading to Japan to shoot an incredible campaign with Asics, so stand by for that. This whole vlog is gonna basically just show the whole journey that we're going on. But yeah, better get inside to the airport to check in and get on that plane for 24 hours of flying. Wish me luck. Guys, so just got up. It's around 9 in the morning here in Tokyo and I've slept approximately 2.5 hours with this jet lag. Been here a few days actually, but since I got here it's kind of been on the go with the shoot with Asics, which has been absolutely incredible, like a completely new experience for me, which yeah, I just am super super grateful for. Unfortunately couldn't shoot anything there, as all the product apparel and sneakers and everything is all kind of under embargo until I think around October when they're gonna release. But the product itself is super awesome. I cannot wait to show you guys that when it does eventually come out. But yeah, that will probably be in a couple of months at least. Today we're gonna just hit the streets again like I've been doing pretty much every day. And this time I get to take you along with me. So let's check them out. Shoe selections, what's it gonna be today? So this is the hood. It's quite cool staying in this area because it's like kind of just outside of Tokyo. It's a very short train trip into the main city center where everything is, where we're going to be heading. It's really, really nice. It like gives you a really cool feel of like, I guess, living in Tokyo as opposed to just like being in a tourist hotspot. This is something pretty cool. I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see it. There we are. It's called the Tokyo Skytree and it is high. All right, so finally at the metro. Let's see. And yeah, this is pretty confusing stuff. All right guys, so we are going to the most famous shopping district like pretty much in the world. Shibuya, Harajuku, all of that. And yeah, just super excited to check all that stuff out, see what happens. All right, so made it through the station relatively unscathed. Now I'm gonna go check out my absolutely crazy favorite coffee shop, or cafe at least, from Maison Kitsune. It's Cafe Kitsune. Let's check it out. That honestly is the greatest cup of coffee I've ever had, and that's why I've had it like every single day. So recharge now, I'm going to go and check out some stores. There are obviously so many stores here, like there is literally everything. Not really a lot of film in a lot of them, so I'm going to show you my favorite ones from what I can, just so you know what to look for if you ever decide to make it over here to Tokyo.
Now for something completely different.
Stop right there, criminal scum!
These are crazy. This is Yun Ambush's collab with Nike. So the Nike Lab store here in Tokyo, MF5, is absolutely insane. I've picked up Fury God raids here just 2 days ago. I got very, very lucky. And then a Matthew M. Williams, the Alix collaboration on the apparel. Picked up an awesome hoodie, so we'll show you that, guys, later. So the Babe store, there are a couple of these all over Tokyo, and I gotta be honest, the one I went into completely put me off buying anything from Babe. Just really like rude stuff, whereas super weird everywhere else you go to. Everyone is super friendly and helpful. In the Babe store, however, they are just complete assholes. You also can't try anything on, well, at least t-shirts and stuff like that. So, I'm absolutely gutted. The first and only thing that I had to get here in Japan was another pair of Rick Owens pants, and I knew the exact ones that I wanted, and unfortunately they don't have my size. Have checked every like retailer of Rick Owens in Tokyo, at least. It's just not working out for me on that one, but if I don't buy those, there's definitely going to be something else that I'm going to replace that with, so let's see what that is. So Acne is like one of my favorite brands. Don't really get a lot of it back in Cape Town. Kind of limited to Loading Bay in Cape Town, maybe some other retailers as well. But to have a full store over here is absolutely incredible. Unfortunately, can't perform inside this one either. But I did manage to pick up some awesome stuff there, which I'll show you later. All right, so now we are in Omotesando. It's kind of a high street kind of thing. So all the Gucci's, Louis Vuitton's, Saint Laurent's, Dior's, etc. You can all find them on the streets and in other places as well, which we'll probably go to. But behind all these crazy stores are where the real heat is lying. Kind of a lot of resale stores and just like cooler clothing, more accessible stuff like that. So we're gonna go there. So if you guys are over here, you got to check out Luke's Lobster behind. It's an American chain of lobster rolls and stuff like that. But I had one yesterday and they're absolutely amazing and they are worth the queue. What? Okay, so we are one of my favorite streets in Tokyo. Definitely have been living over here. There's just so many awesome stores in the space in Omotesando, including the original store. So we're going to check that out quickly. Such a cool store. Been here a couple of times. As you can see, there's some stuff that's still sitting on the shelves, 4Ds, things like that. They're just not that popular here, or there was just like crazy amounts of stock. One thing that's really cool about Japan is that they literally change the store layout pretty much every single day. So these are the consortium ultrabus that are dropping in South Africa, I think this coming weekend, but we don't get this colorway. This one is so much better. Might have to cop those. A friend of mine suggested that come check out Great Burger. Apparently one of the best burger joints here in Tokyo. I just ordered a bacon and cheese Wagyu beef burger with a Coke. Super excited.
Oh my god!
Okay, I'm not bullshitting you just because I'm in Japan or whatever, but this, and I know my burgers, this is the best burger that I've ever had in my life. Like, this is it, 100%. So now we are in Shibuya, might have heard of the crossing, etc., but there are some crazy hype stores over here. My favorite of which is right behind me here, Rinkin. And I picked up a pair of shoes from here, but I'll show you later. It really is something else. Let's check it out. the selection here is just next level. And there are loads of those stores all over the place. Not going to get to them all. But yeah, I'd say from resale price of, or point of view, things are just crazy expensive here. They're not really affected by global market prices as far as I can tell. I think that's a similar thing to what we have in South Africa with import tax, shipping, all of that stuff. So it sucks, but probably saved a lot of money. It's so good. It's like literally so good. I've had every flavor now, every day. We're gonna head back on to Harajuku now, show you guys a little bit around those back streets and some of the craziest stores that I've ever seen. Yo, and she came with the same type game, the type of girl giving out the fake cell phone, the name big fame, big she fame. Like catching big things, jewel ship, money clip, phone flip the six range, and seen her on the ass, spotted her more than once. Ass so fat that you can see her from the front. She spot me like paparazzi, shot me a glance, and that cat woman stands with the fat booty pants. Damn. Maybe I'll definitely have this soon. Yeah, what a shit. Low key, but couldn't keep it down. Asked her to dance, and she was like, yo, I'm leaving now. An hour later, Sam's from Jamaica. She sipping Chris straight up, shaking while in the waist up. Scene two. My fam throwing the jam. Fareed is on the stand. Big things is in the plan. The brother Big Moon makes space for me to move in here. Yo, this my man, Mos. Baby, let me introduce. I turn around. You was the same pretty bird who I had priorly observed. Trying to play me. So, this has been one of my best finds in Tokyo. It's called Studios. This is basically a whole bunch of Japanese designers, like a collective of some sort, and all of them are available in this one store. So it's everything from Yukiyoji Yamamoto to designers that I've never heard of, but it's definitely worth a look. So I just stumbled into the store, which has probably the best prices on resale that I've seen in the entire of Tokyo. Almost market related, slightly over, but not like double like the rest of the resale stores. And the greatest thing ever is I just found a Sneaker Lab wipe sample from the store being given out, which is incredible. They have a South African brand in one of these stores so randomly. That's awesome. Shout out Sneaker Lab. She blew my whole head with that dude. I was like, what? I played it low though. I was like, yeah, all right, come on then, let's go. This is mad. This is so sick. I'm telling you, honey was so blazing. She was pretty much just walked up that crazy tourist street, Takeshita Street, because that's kind of the entrance to like Harajuku area and whatever where all the cool shops are. But there's one shop in particular that you guys need to visit. It's called Nubian and it is amazing. Currently there is a Mains pop-up store here, so let's check that out. So as you can see, pretty epic store. We've got all the biggest brands in there. Got one more store that I'm gonna hit today. All right guys, so we've made it. We are here at GR8, great. The guys literally wear gloves on their hands and they just polish things and keep things clean the entire time. Never seen anything like it, so sick. Definitely like one of my favorite brands. It's so nice to be able to get it without having to pay customs and all of that, importing it to Cape Town. Copped a couple of items from the store and excited to show you them later. All right guys, so that is pretty much day one of the crazy shopping that is available around here in Tokyo. Tomorrow I'm gonna take you down to Ginza, which is even crazier, Dover Street Market, etc. So I'll see you there. All right guys, so as promised, gonna head out to Ginza. So let's take the train and check them out. Ginza, this is the big crossing behind me, and check how crazy these cars are. Ginza is basically just, in my opinion, this like super loaded area. Like all the stores and stuff are just like absolutely next level. Go to in particular and show you guys Dover Street Market. I know they're not going to let me film inside there, but I'm going to at least show you a little bit from the outside and maybe sneak some footage in. It's just unbelievable. So that was Dover Street Market Ginza, now on the roof garden top. Couldn't really film too much in there, but they've got all the greatest brands that you can think of all under one roof, so to speak, or six floors. Definitely give that a check out if you come here. What up, Wesley?
Hey, bro.
How are you, man?
What's happening? Hello, hello, Sneakers Stories TV. Yo, it's quite hot here in Tokyo. Ginza, definitely not an economy recession.
Definitely no recessions over here.
No recession, yeah.
No recessions. Dude, this is a dope place, man. Alright guys, so final day in Tokyo and just hitting up the last few stores that I've been dying to check out. Right behind me is the brand new Apna store. It is unbelievable. Let's get inside and check it out. This store is only about 3 weeks old. I saw it on Instagram, I had to check it out. It's absolutely insane. It's kind of similar to my room. It's obviously just so much better. That is like room goals right there. We're now gonna go check out Worm Tokyo. It's one of the most famous resale stores, and maybe a couple of other places on the way before I have to leave for the airport. Glad I left Worm till the last. Probably the greatest store here in Tokyo for all sneakers and stuff. I don't have any money to just jump at so many of the like ridiculously cool pairs of shoes. It's definitely worth the visit and bring lots of cash. Alright, so the journey home begins now at like 30 something hours. What happened?
What happened? Sweat. Sweat happened.
On the way to the airport. Yeah. Running a little late.
Very.
Hopefully our guy will get us there on time.
We're doing death for some
reason. Take the gap. I'm in the loop.
See you now, upstairs, guys.
Coming through.
I think we can physically go any higher.
Oh, we do need to go higher.
Okay, it's gonna be a long flight.
We made it, guys.
Desperate measures.
Desperate measures, bro.
Last minute purchases, yeah. Flat packing boxes.
Yeah, I don't know what to do. I'm panicking.
Everyone, this is Devin.
Wait.
He's the photographer.
No. I'm out.
He's given up. He's given up. Given up. We're going home. So as you can see back here in the room at Sneaker Stories HQ, what an insane trip Tokyo was. A huge shout out to Asics for having me on the shoot. I cannot wait to see the retouched images and all of that to come out later in probably around October. And I can't wait to share that all with you guys when I'm allowed to. But obviously, I want to show you what I picked up in the most awesome shopping districts of Tokyo. And starting off with the shoes, these, as mentioned in Nike Lab, managed to pick up at retail. It's the Air Fury God Raids. And they are absolutely unbelievable in hand. They kind of go hand in hand with the Air Fury God ones. So both of these having in the pack, especially the colorway for winter, is really, really awesome. Cannot wait to get those on feet. And then a grail of mine that I've been having issues buying for so long is the Balenciaga Speed Trainer, the OG, of course. Managed to pick this up at Rinkin, which is one of the best reseller stores in Tokyo, and they've got a couple of branches around all the major suburbs. But this particular pair, I couldn't say no to it. This is probably the third opportunity I've had to buy it. And super comfortable on foot. We'll do full reviews of all of these shoes. Really stoked with those two pickups. And then while I was in Tokyo as well, I scooped up another two pairs of shoes online, which I had shipped down here as well. This one is definitely going to be a firm favorite for me. It's the Sakai Waffles in the green and orange colorway. Absolutely a beautiful shoe. It's just at sight, and I have slipped this one on foot already, and I can tell you that they are just even better on foot than I was expecting. And then a big guy, also unbelievable shoe, the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1. This is just insane in hand, like to actually finally have this pair. One thing I will say, the quality control on these things is absolutely dog shit. That's not to say that they are terrible or anything. There's just a couple of things you're not used to seeing on Air Jordan 1, which even makes you question authenticity, but that's a stuff up from Nike's side on that. Other than that, the materials are absolutely unbelievable. And then next up, I'm going to show you the clothing that I picked up. So I think I'm just going to take a little step back. And the first up is this Babe t-shirt that I picked up from the Babe store. Obviously, it's got a tiny little logo up here in the front, which is nice and understated. And then on the rear of the shirt, you've got the Bathing Ape sort of ape logo on the back, which is really awesome. And then next, this Billionaire Boys Club t-shirt, which is just a plain black with the Billionaire Boys Club logo here in white, and nothing on the back as far as I know, hopefully. And then also I got a white version of that as well, and that's how they come packaged. So just two pretty plain t-shirts for that as well. And then from Dover Street Market, I picked up this Comme des Garçons black range with Nike. Beautiful t-shirt here with this chromed out gold swoosh on it, and a whole bunch of other detailing on the shirt as well. And then also picked up this awesome long sleeve t-shirt, which is a synthetic material from Comme des Garçons black as well, and Nike, with a whole bunch of different logo paraphernalia on the sleeves. So this one is awesome for winter. Then keeping it with the winter long sleeves, I've also got this beautiful bluey color long sleeve t-shirt from Ambush. It's got a tiny little Ambush logo right here if you get in really close. And then on the back, you've got the main branding in yellow as well. Really awesome store that. Wish I could have picked up more from there, but this was all they had in my size. Then for one of my favorite brands from Nigo, it's the Human Made, and this is the Human Made Dry Oars logo t-shirt in the black, and then I got it in white. And then, of course, one more t-shirt from there, from one of their awesome establishments, Curry Up, and it looks like this. And this is one of my favorite designs from the Curry Up collection on Human Made. One thing you do want to be careful of if you are ordering t-shirts from Human Made is the sizing. As you'll notice, it does have quite a high neck, so if you're not used to that, be careful of it. And the sizing as well, as mentioned, you'll need to go up quite a few sizes. This is actually a 2XL, which is two sizes over my usual, just to get that kind of fit, and it's not too short, if you know what I mean. But moving on, from Lululemon, which is a brand that I don't usually shop at, but my wife got me into it. They make this awesome, I think it's called the 7-year t-shirt, and I've got about five of them now in different colors, so I picked up a whole bunch of other ones. I just like how plain they are. The materials are really awesome, and they come at a really good price. And then moving on to the winter stuff, I found this jacket from a local Japanese company called Harvest, and they make a whole bunch of different products, from apparel, bags, or clothing, all of that kind of stuff. And this was a lightweight rain jacket, which I really liked. It is a black and gray dark camo print on it, and I don't know, just was really nice, so I got it. And then this, one of my favorite pieces from Comme des Garçons. I picked this up at a pop-up store of theirs just off the main street in Omotesando. And it's really awesome. It's a nice overcoat kind of look. And then on the back, you've got the Comme des Garçons branding there, which is really awesome. And apart from that, it's very, very basic, which I like, and very plain, which I obviously like as well. And then I picked up this awesome zip-up hoodie from Rick Owens. I didn't manage to get the pants that I really wanted as they didn't have my size. So this was a little bit of a makeup for that. It's something very nice for winter. It is quite long in its length itself, which is typical of Rick Owens, and you've got the extended lace things on here as well. But really warm and really comfortable, as with all Rick Owens stuff. And then this awesome black crew neck from Mason Kasune and Cafe Kasune, or at least that's the branding on it. You guys would have seen earlier in the vlog, I frequented that coffee shop pretty much every single day I was in Tokyo. You should definitely check that out and definitely grab one of these awesome quality crew necks while you're at it. And then this from Matthew M. Williams, Alix, and Nike Lab. This is one of the greatest hoodies I've ever put on, and I knew the minute I put it on, I had to buy it immediately. The quality, the warmth, everything on it is unbelievable, and the technical design that Alix brings to the table is second to none. Everywhere you look on this hoodie, there is some part of technical design going on, and they're all really functional, so that's a win. Then on top of that, I picked up some accessory stuff as well, and then I picked up this awesome chest rig from Official California. This is something that I never actually thought I was going to rock in my life, because it's like super Hypebeast, but I have to be honest, I absolutely love it, and it was super functional, especially being in a place like Tokyo where you're walking around a lot and you need good access to your stuff, especially with cameras now, etc., just to be able to pull things out on the whim. So this is an absolute win, and I'm probably going to end up wearing this thing a hell of a lot more than I expected. Two pairs of shorts. I know we're going into winter, but I had to get more shorts, and these are from Acne Studios, which is one of my favorite brands, and I put these on as well. Super comfortable, really good quality. I've got this blue pair and then this sort of coppery pair as well, which I've been wearing pretty much non-stop in Japan, and now even though I'm back here in winter, they are still good. And then last but not least, I also had to pick up some treats, well, at least what's left of them. So a whole bunch of different Kit Kats. These ones are like matcha flavor. These things over here called Poifels are like the best jelly beans that you'll ever eat. I think my wife finished most of the stuff, to be honest, but, or maybe I did before she kills me. Lots of more Kit Kats, other flavors, kind of cranberry ones as well, and then some other chocolates which have survived until today, but probably not for long. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. There were some other things that I was hoping to get there in Tokyo, but I just didn't manage to get them in time. And also on the way back, the Remoa that I was hoping to buy, you guys might have seen that earlier in the video. I was saving it for the Dubai duty free, and I couldn't believe it when I got there. They dropped me at the wrong terminal, and I'm still cut up about that. But anyway, life goes on, and I will definitely be going back to Tokyo. I hope you guys have enjoyed my first official vlog right here on Sneaker Stories, and hoping to do a hell of a lot of more stuff like this. Probably not as long and as in-depth as what we have done here today, because this has taken forever to edit. But I hope you guys enjoyed it anyway. I'm really excited to be here on YouTube and to move all of our reviews and other content that I've got planned for the future onto this channel. So stay tuned. Please give this video a like and subscribe down here if you are wanting to follow along with this journey. I'm really, really, really psyched to be on it. Otherwise, thanks very much for watching again. I'll catch you back here soon.